Hi everyone, I think you're all hungry, so I'll make this quick. Out of order. Sorry, I'm not changing it though. I'll not keep you too long, I promise, but this is the only time I'll have such a big captive audience to embarrass my brother. If we've not met yet, I'm Chris, I'm Ant's long-suffering brother and default best man, since he wore down all his friends to the point where they refused. Unfortunately, it's harder for me to refuse. Unfortunate for him too, since I've definitely got the most dirt on him. There was a bit where I was going to read out some messages from people that couldn't make it, but I think that got lost. So we'll skip that. Ant. Prince Charming? My favourite story about Ant. Sorry, I've got to hold the mic. Shows what kind of a person he really is. Really gets to the antlers that bounces around that big lump of a head and occasionally finds its way out into the normal world where we live. It happened when we were 12 or 13, having a pub lunch somewhere in Stoke-on-Trent. And after the plates had been cleared, I had an idea. It was an intelligence test, but I didn't know that at the time. It was just an idea. Oh, at least I I leaned across the table and I said, Ant, if you want, you can kick me as hard as you want, and I won't say anything to anyone, and I won't do anything about it. You, me, everyone here, we'd question that. It's a very obvious trap. At the very least, you'd have a quick look under the table to line up your swing or check for obstacles. I won't drag it out because you know he swung straight away as hard as he could without a second thought. How do you maliciously trust someone? It's not normal. Anyway, Staffordshire wrought iron with elaborate pointy edges makes for great table legs. Not kind to shins. I was honestly surprised with the effort he put in. If that solid metal hadn't been there, I'd have been in trouble. And people knowingly let this man work with radioactive material. It's all the proof you need that we're living in a simulation. But at least now he's got a car, he will no longer leave it at the bus stop. You're not supposed to say that. Who works with Ant? Okay. So he's an idiot, and Kang, you have taken legal responsibility for him. But as you know, under all those layers of wondrous stupidity, he is one of the kindest and most generous people you'll ever meet. And I mean that, he really is. A bit like Shrek. Turn your head to the side. There it is. He's got a track record of helping people when they need it. From helping me that one time I had too much to drink, to taking down a dangerous Dalry crime syndicate, using nothing but his sheer weight to pin them to the ground. Luckily, the police arrived before he'd fully compressed them, but they were never the same after. Now, according to the best man's speech guide, and I did Google it, this part is for me to give you marriage advice. My marriage advice. I've got nothing. Don't plan a wedding for 2020. That's about it. If I had to guess, being kind to each other in hard times, you've made it this far, so I'm sure you're doing something right. If you figure it out, you can tell me at my wedding. Kang, please take good care of this man-child. If he ever gets too much, just find a table with solid iron legs and time to kick it. He'll do it. He'll have forgotten all about this. And he'll just go for it again. Thanks for everyone for being here today and sharing in this wonderful day. Thanks to our bridesmaids and groomsmaids. Your only job's now are to get smashed. There's a guy in a kilt and he's got some of the good stuff. Just find him later. And thanks to all of you for coming. If you could raise your glasses again. To Ant and Kang.